Welcome back to Redbird Projects. Today we're doing something super fun and super easy, so all of you guys should do it. It's the twist dress that you may have seen on some fashion blog sites. And I was inspired by Victoria Beckham's 2013 Spring Summer collection, where she has really cool high necklines, which I wanted to incorporate in the dress. So luckily I had a top that I could use, but if you guys want to use a tank top or a spaghetti strap top, then that's fine too. Just trace it out and fold it in half, then fold your material in half, and then pin your pieces of paper to the material, and then cut around it, which is what I'm doing now. Unfortunately, my top was too small. Like, I realized when I had the paper up against my chest, it was definitely not going to work. So I had to cut like half an inch or more around it, and then but I wanted my seam allowance to be a quarter inch, so I just added on material, if you know what I mean. And then just add your notches so you know where to sew, and then get a longer dress, or you can eyeball it and cut around that. Unfortunately, the dress design had a kind of like a hip bit, and it kind of created like a bulge. You'll see in the final bit, you'll notice that there's a bit of puckering near the hip or lower hip. So yeah, that was a bit of a problem. Also, I noticed that the front bit, like, I couldn't duplicate it just because I knew it wouldn't fit me, so I had to make the back bigger, which is what you just saw me cutting around it. Hopefully, yours will fit properly if you do it right the first time, unlike me. Here I'm just sewing the shoulder bits. I really should learn the proper terminology, because I'm pretty sure it's not called shoulder bits. But yeah, so I did it twice. Just for extra support, and then I added like a zigzag stitch on top of it for a further support. I also did like two stitches on the side seams as well, and just remember to back stitch at the beginning and at the end. Yeah, so you'll notice like I just stop like right here. I think I do it again. I'm pretty sure I do it again. Right? Yeah, there. It's because I was watching Jerry Springer and it got good, so got a little distracted. Anyway, so once you do that, you, then you do your side seams. So I did a quarter inch for the shoulder bit and the side seams. If you have more material to use, then you can make your side seams as, like, you can have a seam allowance of a half an inch, or, you know, it really just depends on what you want to do. So this is the fun bit. You have to cut triangles into your waist. Make sure they're the same. You don't want a wonky cutout, I guess. So there I am, making sure it's the same size, eyeballing it with my fingers. You guys can use a ruler. That's your safest bet. So once you finish trimming the triangles or cutting the triangles out, you pull the skirt bit inside out, and then you do that twice so it becomes the right side out. And that's it. You've got your dress all ready to go. So I hope this was easy to follow. If you do have any problems or you need some questions answered, then by all means, just inbox me or write to me or somehow on Facebook or something, and I'll get back to you. So here's the final look, guys. Thanks for watching.
Everything I tried to do. That's sound, something like beholding you. I know this can make you understand.